Scottish Football Podcast with Stephen Mill and Ewen Cameron.
Hello and welcome to the Big Scottish Football Podcast with me, Ewen Cameron. There is no Stephen Mill today because he is in Barcelona with his lovely wife, Anna. Stephen, I know you'll be listening. Have a lovely time. We'll see you next week. This is episode 72. So, it's me, Ewen Cameron, with a very special guest. He's been a regular on the podcast for a number of weeks now, and you've all been itching for him to join us live in the studio, and we're delighted that he is here with us today. My co-host for today and our very special guest started his career at Benfica. He is a Hamilton legend that played for Hearts, St Mirren, Kilmarnock, and just about every other club in Scotland. Please welcome to the Big Scottish Football Podcast, the one, the only,
Jose.
That's
amazing.
We have to start the show by being very honest with the listeners and the viewers on YouTube, because Jose Quitongo revealed to us around 10 minutes ago before we recorded this show that he doesn't like football and he doesn't watch football. So this could be a really short podcast. So you've not watched any of the games from the weekend?
No, I've not been watching football for ages. I just feel football. No, I just feel football not the same.
What do you mean?
Because football now, they're like robot. You know what I mean? In my time when we used to play, we have like entertaining things like that. See, now just straight like don't have time to finish. You know what I mean? I just feel now a lot of kids go watch the game. The kids get bored because nothing like, you know, excited. That's why.
So when did you give up on football?
Oh, soon I retired, and you know what I mean? I've been coaching all that stuff. And then my sons play.
There's your son.
Yeah.
Jai.
Mm-hmm.
He plays with Morton.
Yeah.
They're on an 11 game unbeaten run.
Yeah.
When did you last go and see him?
Oh, I don't know.
Do you not even watch your son?
No.
You don't like football?
I know. I lost the love for football. Yeah. It's just not the same. You're not the same. The football, you know what I mean? They take off fun. You know what I mean?
But you're here to talk about the weekend's football.
Yeah, I'm not watch football. I'm just going to talk. You know what I mean? It's me. I'm just going to talk whatever, you know?
So when I talk about the Premiership, the mm-hmm. Championship, League mm-hmm. One and League Two, you have no idea what's going on.
No, I don't know who's playing, who's...
Do you know who's top of the league?
No. I don't know. In the Premier League, I know Celtic in the top for five points. Yeah, Celtic in the top for 5 points. Rangers have 1 game in hand, because one of the boy I coach tell me that. You know? I'm not...
Do you know where Hearts are in the league?
No.
It's one of your former clubs.
I know. Locke actually phoned me when last week forgot to this Saturday watch the game. But I can't. You know what I mean? I lied to him. I say I can't. I go to Aberdeen.
This is going to be an interesting podcast, isn't it? Jose Quitongo's here and he doesn't watch football and doesn't like football, yet this is a football podcast. God help me. Mm-hmm. John, of all the people we could have booked for today, producer John, we bring in Jose Quitongo. Can we not ask him these questions last week if he watches the games or not?
Yeah, but the hits are going to go flying because he is the coolest man in Scottish football.
Hold on, I was going to move your microphone a wee bit. That's all right, stay where you are. Right, okay. Are we ready to do this then?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, mm-hmm. let's do it. Let's start mm-hmm. with some of the feedback that we get.
Okay.
And there's a lot of people who are loving the idea of you joining us on the podcast. Mm-hmm. So I want to say good morning to CB97QS, I think maybe a Queen of the South fan, possibly. Mm-hmm. Every week, Jose puts a smile on your face with his happy energy without fail. Why are you always so happy?
You know why? The reason's why, because I live alone. One.
No, it's you're true. Happy because you live alone.
Yeah, live alone.
Do you not want to have a relationship? Do you not want to have a woman in your life?
No, the problem, I'm so happy with me, you know what I mean? Because I live alone, I do my own thing, I have my routine, can do every single day, you know what I mean?
Are you not lonely?
No, I entertain myself, I wake up in the mirror. One more thing, I always say that to my friends. When I wake up, I do my prayer, and then I have a mirror next to my room, and then I look in the mirror, look myself in the mirror, look, I say, Jose, you know what? I love you. And I kiss the mirror, And then go, I swear, my kids like, oh, you crazy. I just feel, this is why, you know, I wake up in the morning like.
Yeah. You kiss yourself in the mirror.
Kiss yourself in the mirror because they say, you love yourself. I need to love myself. You know what I mean? I don't depend on somebody to love myself, to love me.
Uh-huh.
I love myself and I'm happy with it.
So your routine every morning is to kiss yourself in the mirror?
Yeah, when I wake up, I kiss myself in the mirror. It, when I go to the bed as well, it's true. Every single day when I go to bed, before I go to bed, I look around, go in the window, look, and then I say, this can be over. Because you never know when you're going to bed, you wake up. You know, I do that.
So you might not. So you're worried you might not wake up.
Yeah, this I'm not worried about. This is the way I just look. I say, well,
this could be it.
Yeah, you know what I mean. This I do. In the morning when I wake up, do the same kiss. Jose, you know what? I love you, pal. You know, it's great. You know.
Right, okay, so that's why you're full of happy energy because you enjoy each day and you're grateful for each day that you live.
Exactly.
Correct. Lovely. That's a great way to look at life, Jose. Good morning to. Well, I keep saying good morning. It's like I'm on the breakfast show. James, hi, James. To you, James, Tony. Ewan's face when the Real Radio intro comes on is quality. It's a pain in the arse, James. I'll be honest with you. Go and just fire off now, just to get it out of the way. Because you're flat, there you go.
This is the Real Football Phone-In with Ewen Cameron and Alan Ruff.
Do you remember that from back in the day? And we don't need to play that at any other point today, producer John. Hello to Fitz. Netflix recommendation for Ewen, Boy Swallows Universe. Great series shot here in Brisbane, Australia. Have you seen that, Boy Swallows Universe?
No.
What's the biggest thing you swallowed? Is this Boy Swallowed a Universe?
Boy swallowed in universe.
The actual universe, he swallowed it.
No.
What have you swallowed anything big?
No.
It's gonna be one of those days. I can just sense it.
Let us get back to your correspondence from It's Like a Jungle. Shanklin staying at Hearts does not guarantee third, so it's a case of banking a few million now or gambling. For more, with his contract age, it would be wise to sell now. Agree, they probably hoped a bit more of interest down south for a bigger fee. So Lauren Shankly, you'll be aware of him.
Yeah.
Heart striker. His contract is up in 18 months. Do Hearts sell him in this window or do they keep him until the summer?
Keep him until the summer, I think, because Hearts need him. He's banging the goals, you know what I mean?
He's banging the goals.
Yeah. I just feel sell him in the summer. You know, keep them until...
But they won't get as much money in the summer. That's the argument.
Yeah, this the situation. If they sell now, they get a lot of money, and then ask who's going to score the goals.
That's a good point.
You know
that's
what I mean?
Good point,
that's the problem.
So keep a hold of
keep
them.
Keep a hold of them.
Okay. From Reese McPike, I really don't see the hype over Shanklin. He's absolutely no pace. He's the best of a bad bunch at heart. Is Shanklin a good player?
I think he's good.
Good striker?
Good striker. For me,
he's are you scored... making this up?
No, I'm not.
You're aware of him?
Yeah, because he's scored goals. Football about scored goals. If you score goals, you win games. You know what I mean? He's a goal machine.
What more do you need?
Yeah, these people complain, oh, he's not a good player. He scored goals. I just feel as if he's going to play for Rangers, also still score more goals because he played better team. You know what I mean?
Are you saying that Rangers and Celtic are better than Hearts?
No, I'm not saying that.
Yes, you did.
No. I'm not saying that.
You just said that if he goes to Rangers or Celtic, he'll score more goals.
No, because the quality of the players,
So they are better than Hearts?
Not better, but it's easier if you play teams like that.
Okay. Big Time Burgers, quote of the year from Ewen. Most people look at me as if I'm speaking sense. Can't decide if his opinions on football are worse than his opinions on movies. What a tosser. Somebody just called me a tosser. Can you confirm or deny that?
No, you're a nice guy.
A tosser?
No.
If you were to describe me in one word, what would it be?
Amazing.
Amazing, lovely, thank you. From Craig Elliott, McFadden is the best Scottish football pundit, James McFadden. Would you have played against him when he was at Motherwell?
Yeah, I played.
Do you remember James McFadden?
Yeah, I talk to James all the time.
Do you like James?
James and Chris, you know when I play with Chris?
Chris who?
Yeah, Chris Boyd.
Did you
play? No, and Kelly. I played with Chris Boyd. Come on.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did you, in the same team as Chris Boyd?
Yeah. Because he was just young that time, yeah.
And was he up front?
He's play up front, yeah.
You supplied the crosses?
Sometime, yeah.
Did you assist a few goals for him?
No, because I don't play a lot of games there. So, you know, I went to Kelly and played a few games and I left to Dubai.
Oh, right. Yeah. So Kilmarnock then Dubai?
Dubai, yeah.
We'll find out more about your career a little later. It's unbelievable the clubs you played for in Scotland.
Yeah, I know.
Big shout out to the Kilmarnock mascot who has been in touch with us after last week's show. Apparently he is now no longer Nuts the Squirrel, but now goes under Captain Conker. He's still a squirrel though. So when you were at Kilmarnock, do you remember the mascot?
Yeah, I remember, yeah.
Squirrel.
Uh-huh.
Do you remember the squirrel?
Yeah.
It was Nuts the Squirrel back then. It's now Captain Conker. So just remember, you can leave a comment anytime on Twitter at Big Football Scott, or you can comment on our YouTube video, which is on YouTube. Just search for the Big Scottish Football Podcast or head to the Super Scoreboard channel. Right, this is going to be interesting because we're now going to go through the games in the Premiership, the Championship, League One and League Two. Yet Jose Quitongo doesn't like football, doesn't watch football, doesn't have a clue what's going on, but we're going to have to go through each of the games.
No problem.
Are you ready?
No problem.
Okay, you're aware of teams like St Mirren and Rangers and Motherwell and all that stuff, and and you know they're... Right, so if I'll just go through the scoreline, you can tell us what you think.
Okay.
Okay, so St Mirren nil, Rangers one. Did they deserve it?
St Mirren...
Nil.
Now?
Nil.
Rangers won.
Dessers scored the goal. Do you know Dessers?
No.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Did you see anything?
No.
No. Rangers winning, is that a surprise?
No, I should. You know what I mean? The Rangers should win or play against teams like St Mirren. I'm not saying St Mirren is a small team, but you know what I mean? I just feel when you play football, when you're playing teams like Celtic and Rangers, this they meant to win all the time.
Yeah, sure.
You know what I mean? Should win, but...
Should win because of their budget.
The budget, yeah. But football these days now has changed because a lot of small teams have a lot of good players. Mm-hmm. They can get, you know what I mean? They can...
They can cause a wee surprise every now and then.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So big win that for Rangers. 1-0. Dessers with a goal. Good goal as well. Mm-hmm. Brilliant pass from Lundstrom into the path of Dessers. Took it round the goalkeeper and slotted it into the empty net. So big win that for Rangers. Then Celtic played Ross County. Mm-hmm. They took the lead after 1 minute, Jose. Mm-hmm. 1 minute.
1 minute.
1 minute. They're in front. You're thinking, right, it's going to be 5-6-7-0. Mm-hmm. 1-0. They scraped a 1-0 win at home to Ross County.
Yes, football. See, football is sometimes crazy. That's not mean sometimes when we used to play, like when I used to play, when we play against Celtic, when we score in the first minute, we say, "Oh my God, today gonna be like heavy
defeat."
You know what I mean?
You're
heavy
worried.
Defeat. Yeah, worried. But that one for win one now. You know, something, just...
So what's the mindset there? That they're 1-0 up, you're thinking, right, it's going to be 2-3-4-5.
Yeah, sometimes when you score, you say, oh, well, today won't be easy.
Easy.
Yeah, bah.
Never turns out that way.
Yeah.
So there you go, Celtic just winning by a goal to nil. And Ross County were unlucky not to score a late equaliser. Because when it's 1-0, as you know,
1-0,
even we chance.
Even 2-1, 2-0 is nothing. Because if the other team score 2-1 and then you start like...
The momentum's with them. Mm-hmm. So see when it's 2-0 or 1-0, were you still scared?
Yeah.
And worried?
Yeah, because the corner, somebody... Like,
free kick,
boom, go.
Done.
You know, 1-1. You can't do nothing. Yeah,
and that nearly happened with Ross County. They had a couple of late chances to equalise against Celtic. And at the end of the game, the Celtic fans were booing the team even though they win 1-0.
You see?
What do you think of that?
No, because expectation. You know, this
but you win the game, why are you booing?
You know, they want like... because they scored the first minute, they expect like 7. You know what I mean? They expect too much from
the
team.
Are they spoiled?
Yeah.
Are the Celtic fans spoiled? Are they expecting too much?
Yeah, this is what happened. But this I always say, when you play teams like that, this expectation, you need to score a lot of goals. Play against teams like that, you need like 5-6.
And great performance.
Yeah.
Playing great football.
Yeah.
So if the football's not great, and you only win by 1-0,
you know,
the fans are not going to be happy.
Yeah, going to be upset. This is what happened. They travel. I can imagine they travel. And the boss like, you know what I mean? Come for the, you know what I mean? That's what happened. It's football.
Yeah, fans weren't they happy. But they got the 3 points and they're clear at the top by 5. But Rangers do have a game in hand. Hearts at home to Aberdeen. Hearts 2. Aberdeen 0. That's Hearts 10 points clear in third and unbeaten in their last 8. Lauren Shankland scored an absolute peach of a goal for the second to secure all 3 points after Jorge Grant had scored from the penalty spot. Hearts outstanding in the second half, thoroughly deserved their win. Barry Robson under all sorts of pressure after that defeat. I think they're like 19 points behind Hearts, who are third. So Barry Robson is under huge pressure. And Dave McCormack is under pressure to sack him.
Oh my God,
Barry Robson. Did you know Barry Robson?
I
did
know,
you ever
play
against him?
I played against him. Yeah, when he's played for Inverness.
Yeah. So, what, did you like him as a player?
Yeah, good player. Was a good player. He moved to Celtic.
That's right.
Yeah. Was a good player.
So he's the manager of Aberdeen. Did you know that?
Yeah, I know. I know he's.
Do you only know that now because I told you?
No, somebody told me before. No, it's you. Somebody told me. Yeah.
So Barry Robson under a lot of pressure. And when you are 19 points behind Hearts in third, that's going to carry a lot of pressure. It's going to. People are going to look for change there. Should Barry Robson be sacked?
Well,
19 points behind third.
90 points.
Should he be sacked?
How long has he been there?
Just since March.
It's March. Well, I don't know. I'm not even see
Aberdeen
play.
I'm asking the record. But, I mean, yeah, it's not great.
Yeah, but sometimes you can give a guy a chance. Why not give?
So if you were Dave Cormack right now, the boy that's in charge at Aberdeen,
but then,
are you sacking Barry Robson?
No, I give another chance. I give him like five games.
Five more games.
Five more games. Well, because the five games, they can turn, you know what I mean? They can win the five.
Right, the next couple of games are Ross County, Rangers and Celtic. That just says it all. So it looks like Barry Robson might be out of a job.
Yeah.
Okay. Kilmarnock 2, Hibs 2. Kilmarnock were 2-0 up in coasting, and Hibs fought back to 2-2. We'll get to some of the VAR decisions shortly, but that again was a really good game. And Newell's goal for Hibs was an absolute peach on the volley, 18 yards out to get Hibs back into the game. But that was actually a good result for Hearts, with Kilmarnock drawn with Hibs 2-2. Livingston 1, Dundee 4. Looks like that's it for Livingston. Their time in the Premiership could be over with that defeat. I think that might be the killer result that just knocks them out completely. I think they will be relegated, losing 4-1 at home to Livingston. And they were down to 10 men as well, Dundee. So not a great result, that. And it would appear as though, listening to David Martindale, that he is resigned to getting relegated to the Championship at the end of the season. Not a great result for Livingston, and I think they've only won like two or three games. I think it's two games this season, so yeah, they're not in a great position. St Johnstone 1, Motherwell 1. The least said about this game, the better. Nothing great. Motherwell thoroughly deserved to win it, but a big point in that for St Johnstone as they try and get themselves away from those relegation places. So that was the Premiership. Who's winning the league, Jose? If Rangers win their game in hand, right, and the games that are coming up, there'd only be 2 points behind Celtic. Who's winning the league?
I don't know. You know what I mean? Celtic not been playing.
Pick one.
I watched the World Farm, the old film, that Celtic Rangers, the one.
Oh, 2-1.
2-1, yeah. Celtic not been playing great as well. I watched that game. Celtic no.
Not great.
Not been playing great. Rangers the same, but I don't know. You know, I don't know.
You have to pick one.
No, I don't know.
Jose, you are here as co-host and pundit, and you have an opinion.
Okay.
So I'm asking you right now, based on the Old Firm game that you watched, you think there was nothing much in it?
Yeah.
You thought there was nothing between the two teams?
Yeah.
Right?
But
who is winning the league?
I don't know.
The next Old Firm game is at Ibrox.
Okay.
And if Rangers win the game in hand, it's 2 points.
Yeah, but long to go.
I'm asking you.
Yeah, but I...
Pick one.
I can't, because impossible, because you never know. I pick that one and then the other one win.
But that's the whole point of having a wee guess or a wee bet. Who are you picking to win the league?
I don't know.
Flip a coin.
Oh,
right, here we go. Heads Rangers, tails Celtic. Flip the coin. You're deciding now. Flip it. What did it land on? Tails. Celtic are winning the league, according to Jose Quitongo in the 50 pence piece.
Don't say that. I keep, never know. I just feel never know.
Oh, you want Rangers to win the league,
I'm
don't you?
Not.
Oh, you do, because
no.
you don't. I bet you if that landed on heads, you'd have been happy for it to be Rangers. Aye. You want Celtic. You want Rangers
know.
To win the league.
No, I love the two teams. No,
you don't. You want Rangers to win.
Ewen, I love the two teams. Aye. I love Celtic Rangers. I love the two teams.
Jose, follow.
Your art. No?
That's not part song.
No. Follow. Yeah.
We will follow on.
Okay. Follow. I don't know that.
Follow. It's a Ranger song.
Oh.
I thought you'd know that.
No, I don't know. I'm not watching. Me? No.
Yeah, you.
You know, Hamilton Arts. This is the teams I played. This is the team that I support.
Okay.
Yeah.
When you walk.
Okay.
You'll never walk
alone. This alone. Liverpool. That's Liverpool song.
No, it's a Celtic song. Oh, you're not doing very well today, Jose Quitongo.
No, but you know, I don't know.
How many times have you played at Celtic Park?
Yeah, a lot of times.
Right, so what's the song they play before the game kicks off?
I'm not even listening because I put, you know what I mean? It's too much noise, your ears, man, block.
Right, so yeah. So you're focused on
the game. Yeah.
You don't hear any of the music.
No.
You don't hear the crowd.
No. You know when you play this, when I used to play this, I just block everything. All the banter, the guys, I shout, I'm no. You know what I just...
So when Rangers played at Ibrox and Hearts, Hamilton, whoever it was that you're playing with at the time, you turned up there. Did you not hear Tina Turner?
The best, simply the best. Just
better than.
Yes, better. You normally when you go to the warm up, yeah, you listen a little bit that.
So you listen to the Rangers songs, but you're not listening to the Celtic songs. That's what you've just admitted to.
No, I'm not saying that.
Yeah, you did.
No,
you said that you're very much focused and you wanted to block out the Celtic fans, but you weren't blocking out the Rangers or their songs.
No, I'm not.
You just said it.
I don't say that. I say that. No, never. I'm not.
You remember listening to Tina Turner at Ibrox, but you don't remember You'll Never Walk Alone.
I said I listened to Tina.
Producer John, tell me I'm not hearing things here.
No, I said when we in the change room, like I can listen simply the bass. Just that.
I believe Jose.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Right, let's get into the championship. Are the wheels coming off race title hopes? What do you think?
Second? I was thinking.
Wraith Rovers, right? They're in the championship, right? Has the wheels fallen off their title ambitions?
No, who's in second place? No, who's in second? Wait. No, wait. Wraith, no, first place?
Dundee United. Wraith are second?
Second. How many points? I don't know. I'm not...
Producer John, who hired this guy?
No, but...
Whose decision was that?
I'm not even... I know I watched the game.
There you go. There's a league table for you. Have a look at that league table.
Dundee United. 45. 44.
Who's in second?
Wraith Rovers.
Yeah, 44. So,
but
one
game. Dundee United have one game in hand.
Yeah,
but that's not mean. It's still, I just feel.
But Wraith Rovers are in a bad run of form just now.
Yeah, but even Greenock Morton, Lunomanoin.
That's your team. That's your boys' team.
Yeah, they have a chance. See now, you know. Now, so if they can go on a run, you know what I mean? I just feel.
So how many games in hand do Morton have? Because that's where your boy is.
Morton have.
How many?
One game.
One game. How many points they got?
They have 29.
29. And what did Dundee United have?
They're 45.
Do you think they can catch them?
Yeah.
What? You think Morton can catch Dundee United?
No, not Morton. Bah. Patrick can catch. Patrick Tuskin.
Patrick Thistle with a chance.
Yeah, have a chance. Because I just feel.
They're on 37.
So if you go on in football like that, sometimes you get a 5 game in a row, like.
Boom, 15 points in the bag.
You know what I mean? Football like that, sometimes, now actually, next month, if you start like. Win, you can go, you know.
Yeah, if you get momentum.
Football.
So Dundee United at the top at the moment. They drew 0-0 with Dunfermline. Yeah. Stephen Mill, who's in Barcelona, will be happy with that. Going to Tannadice, tough place to go.
Yeah.
0-0 against Dundee United. Mm-hmm. You must have played at Tannadice.
Yeah.
Did you like Tannadice?
I love that part.
What was their favourite song? Do you remember?
No.
Again, so it just proves everything.
No, I'm
he's
not
a Rangers man.
No, I'm not.
You remember it? You don't remember any other song other than Simply the Best?
No, Simply the Best because Tina Turner.
You like Tina Turner?
Yeah, that's why.
Okay. So there you go. Dundee United 0-0 against Dunfermline. Wraith Rovers are on the slide. Partick Thistle, though, played 22 on 37. Mm-hmm. What was the Partick Thistle score at the weekend there? Oh, 1-1 away to Airdrie. Do you know Airdrie?
Yeah.
Do you like Airdrie?
Yeah, I like all the teams, yeah.
No, but do you like the town?
The town, Airdrie? No, not too much, no.
Just leave it at that, it's fine. Don't dig yourself a bigger hole.
That's I know.
Don't give me doing that. Let's get into League One because producer John, who you met, and who called you to get you here today, he's a Falkirk fan.
Okay.
And Falkirk are the league leaders. Have a look at that league table. They went away to Alloa at the weekend and they won by 5-0.
Alloa is the place to play.
Yeah, look at that league table. Look at Falkirk, how well they're doing, Jose.
I know, but we've got remember, Jose is a Hamilton legend here, he'll be gutted at the moment because Hamilton dropped two points at the weekend and then throws late on.
Look at the league table.
I think Falkirk should win easily.
The league. What's the points difference?
The points difference is Falkirk have 56. Aki's have 45.
Yeah, we've got 11 points clear at the moment, Jose.
Yeah, I just feel if they don't win the league,
look how many games Falkirk have lost. Zero. Unbeaten.
That's good because who's the manager?
John McGlynn. You must know John McGlynn. Was he not there at Hearts with you?
Yeah.
What was he like?
He's nice man, quiet guy. Yeah.
Are you surprised he's a manager?
No, he's have that. You know what I mean. Even before, he used to take the young boys, all that stuff. He's a nice man.
Good coach.
Good coach. Yeah.
Good coach. So, Falkirk are flying. 5-0 winners against Alloa.
They should win the league.
What about Hamilton? Do you see them catching Falkirk?
Going to be difficult, but...
They've got a game in hand and are 11 behind.
Oh.
So, if they win their game in hand, it goes to 8.
And then 2 weeks' time, Hamilton are at the Falkirk Stadium as well. That's going to be
that's the game.
That's the game. But it's still long to go. I just feel a lot of games. Yeah, a lot of games.
I tell you, John, I don't know if you agree with me on this one when you're looking at League One. Mm. The team that's on a decent wee run just now, Queen of the South, that's Marvin Bartley, who's a regular on Super Scoreboard. He's turned things around there. Yeah. I think they've got a great chance of getting themselves into the playoffs.
Yeah, big result for them up in Cove at the weekend. They're beating them by 2-0. And Marvin's side face Hamilton this Saturday at Palmerston as well. So I'll be speaking to Marvin and having a word in his ear and just saying that the Hamilton boys play Call of Duty they don't care what you say about computer games, Marvin. They've been on the FIFA, they've been on Call of Duty, and they say, what does Marvin Bartley know? Just to get him a wee bit of head up, get it up on the dressing room, you know. There we go. So hopefully you'll get a result against Hamilton next Saturday.
Stephen Mill, who's in Barcelona, as you well know, if you're a regular listener, the podcast will know that Stephen's dad is involved at Kelty Hearts. Well, they had an absolute stinker at the weekend. They lost at home by 5-0 to Stirling, and Kelty Hearts dropped to 8th on 24. Annan and Edinburgh City are 9th and 10th. They're going to be stuck in those positions for the rest of the season. Do you know Joe Biden? Who's Joe Biden?
Is the American president? No.
He is the American president, yeah. And do you know that Joe Biden, right? He watches more Scottish football than you.
Yeah.
He loves League Two.
No.
He's a huge fan of League Two. And every Sunday night, he sends us his report of League Two in Scotland.
That's great.
You don't believe me?
No, I'm not. I believe you. Why
okay,
not?
Well, would you hear from him?
No, it's
great. Joe Biden is about to... tell us about League Two now, with Donald Trump looking like he will be his opponent in the election and the continuing crisis in Iran. The President of the United States has a lot on his plate. That may be the case, but that does not get in his way of his love for Scotland's League Two.
It's great.
You know, I'm delighted that you have finally got an ex-Denny player into the studio. No one will ever forget Jose's 10-game spell with the Warriors back in 2010. What a guy. Anyway, in the words of Rod Stewart, I don't want to talk about it. Stenhouse Moore's 12-game winning run came to an end against the Fish Lovers Peterhead, although we are still 13 points clear at the top. Dumbarton got back to winning ways with a 1-0 win over Elgin. He's 5-1 with the same scoreline against Stranraer, and Clyde went 3-unbeaten with a draw against the Spartans. Elsewhere, it was a no-score draw between the Bridey Lovers and Bonnie Rig Rose. Well, better get back to it. People keep trying to fake my voice. I mean, who would even do that? See you later, guys.
That was Joe Biden.
Something like,
familiar. Something of your career.
Who's that?
That's Joe Biden.
Ah, come on.
He sent us that from Washington, yeah, from the White House last night.
Man, it sounds like.
It is Joe Biden. What do you mean it sounds like him? It is Joe Biden. So that's your roundup of the weekend's action. Are we going to do WTF, VAR WTF now?
Do you want to do that or do you want to do the transfer roundup, Ewan? Mm-hmm.
Let's do the transfer roundup first and then we'll do VAR WTF. So go and fire off the bed.
Okay.
Right, Jose, there you go, mate. Just go and read out those couple of stories, some of the transfers that have gone through in recent days.
Which one? That one? Rangers?
Yeah, the Rangers one, your favourite team.
What's my favourite team?
Just read that out.
That's not my favourite team.
Read that out.
Rangers signing.
Do it in front of the microphone.
Who's this guy? Fucking hell. I need my glasses, man.
Just read it out.
Yeah. Rangers signer. Where's this guy's... You know, what's that guy's name?
No, that's where he's from.
Oh, he's... Oh. Let me see.
Ivorian.
Ivorian.
Yeah.
Ivorian?
Yeah.
Okay. Rangers signer, Ivorian midfield, Mohamed... Yeah? Mohamed... Fuck's sake, what's his name? Mohamed... Mohamed Diama from I can't say the next second name. Mohamed Diamante?
Yeah.
Mohamed Diamante from Dutch club. Fucking hell, man. What's this? Dutch club. What's that club called?
Just read what it says.
Fuck sick. What's this club? Norch. Fucking hell. I can't pronounce this thing, man. Oh, you come on, man. You give me that name. I can't say that name. Come on. You know, what's that name?
Just read it as you see it. Just read it as you see it.
That name? The team?
From the start, and then get to the team that he's coming from.
Okay.
Right, do it in front of the microphone.
Okay.
Okay, you're now the news reader.
Okay.
Break the news. Break the news!
Okay. you're laughing, man. Come on. Rangers signing new fucking hell. I've already midfield Mohamed Diamante from Dutch club. This Dutch club is fuck Dutch. I can't say that one. I can't say that team. Oh no, come on. You don't know. I'm not gonna say that team. I can't say that team. What's name that team? Yeah, come on. You put it things very difficult for me. Come on.
Neuschland.
Neuschland,
yeah.
Sounds crazy,
okay,
man.
See, Killian Phillips, try that one then. Do that one. That's easier.
Okay. Kevin Phillips.
No.
Oh, Killian Phillips. I was thinking the guy played for City.
It's not Calvin Phillips, it's Kelvin.
Killing Philip as enjoyable deal. Yeah?
Yeah, go on.
Kylan Philip enjoy Aberdeen, a diversity midfield, enjoy alone until the end of the season.
Yeah.
From Crystal Palace.
Yeah.
You know? Jackson, no, that's done.
You can do more if you want.
Oh, no.
The big Air United story.
Yeah. Jackson enjoy Air United. Alone to the end of the season.
Yeah.
Done?
The reason I gave you that is because I was struggling with the Rangers signing.
See this one?
Yeah.
I can't say that name. The name is Mohamed Diamante, yeah?
Yeah, that's right. That's all good, but I couldn't get the club team.
You know?
No.
You can't. Impossible.
That one there. Go and do that one for me as well.
What one?
No, that one.
Okay.
From Liverpool.
Okay. James.
Yeah.
You crazy.
Because I struggle every week with this.
Fuck, what's your second name? James Balanzier. Yeah? Aye. James Balanzier, enjoy Kelly.
Join where?
Huh?
Where's he going?
No, Kelly.
Oh, come on.
Yeah. Enjoy Kelly. Yeah, come on. Enjoy Kelly. one session along deal from Liverpool. And Jose Quitongo's the new coach. I'm joking.
No.
Just that one, yeah?
So there you go. Because, see, I have to do that every week, and okay. I always struggle.
See the name of that Mohamed? Where he come from? He play for?
Ivory Coast.
Ivory Coast. He's a good player.
Under 23s. 4.3 million.
You saw him play?
I've not seen him play, no. I'm not that familiar with him.
Okay.
But he's from the Danish club Nordsjælland, and he's under 23 Ivory Coast player, midfielder. And so they've got him on loan, but they will buy him in the summer for £4.3 million.
Well, they need to see first, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah, totally. Yeah. No, but they've already agreed they're going to pay that, even if he turns out to be shit.
Oh my God.
So he's a young player with a lot of potential.
But Scotch football, I played a lot of different countries. I talk with a lot of guys foreign, played a lot of different countries. Scotch football is unique. You can be the best player in Barcelona, England, come in Scotch football. If you know adapt Scotch football, you shit. No, it's true.
No, you're talking about Sam Lammers.
No.
Because he was at Rangers and then he went to Utrecht and now he's brilliant at Utrecht, but was rubbish for Rangers.
Yeah, Scotch football is unique. It's very unique.
I mean, you've played all over the world.
Yeah, but
is Scottish football for you the hardest league that you played in?
Yeah, the hardest and the best. Fastest
and the hardest.
Yeah, because I remember when I went to Italy play, I get the ball, try run the guy. Jose, relax. Because the way we play here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's great. Scotch football, the best.
This is why
all the Scotch players go playing abroad do well. Because you play here. You know what I mean?
It's hard. It's physical. It's quick.
Yes. If you adapt Scotch football, you can play
anywhere in the world.
Yeah.
So that's why you think a lot of young players from Scotland are now moving to Germany and Italy and places like that.
Do well because it's easier. You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah. Got you. Yeah. So shall we talk about some of the rumours that are flying around?
Yeah, let's
go. Do I need a bit of music for this? What is... Oh, yeah, I like that. Do you know Only Fools and Horses?
Yeah.
TV show?
Yeah, I watched one.
Yeah, it's good.
No, the guy's the yellow...
Yellow car. Rangers have accepted a bid from Turkish club Rizespor. Rizespor. What's that?
That one.
That one there.
Rizespor.
Rizespor. Rizespor. For Jose Cifuentes, who was only signed for Rangers in the summer, it's going to be an initial loan with the option to buy for around £2 million. But however, I've got some breaking news on this. Cifuentes is apparently not keen on moving to Turkey. That's the story that we're hearing this morning. Mm-hmm. Oscar Cortez, is that right? Producer John Cortez, we're going with that?
Cortez, it's a Spanish name.
Yeah, it's Cortez, yeah.
Cortez. He's edging closer to joining Rangers for the Colombian whiz kid. He's okay. Colombian and he's a whiz kid. Okay. Mm-hmm. And they're going to be signing him on loan. He's from Lons. Where's Lons?
Lons. Lons, that's Switzerland?
No. That's Luzerne.
Luzerne.
Lons is baguette.
Baguette.
That's a clue.
Lons, baguette. Belgium?
No. Eiffel Tower. Eiffel Tower.
Well, fuck it. Eiffel Tower.
Disney Paris.
France.
Yes. So he might be joining Rangers. What else have we got here? The left back that Rangers try to sign, the Brazilian left back. Is it Jefty, I think his name is. Mm-hmm. It looks as though he will be making the move to Rangers. Sure. That's a left back. For Celtic, Sidney Van Hooijdonk, son of Pierre, is rumoured to be attracting Celtic attention.
He's a good player.
Pierre Van Hooijdonk. Do you know Pierre Van Hooijdonk? Yeah. Did you play against him?
Yeah.
Was he a good striker?
Very good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
His son
is very good as well. I saw a wee clip on YouTube. Very good player.
He could be coming to Celtic.
Yeah.
Would that be a good signing?
Good signing, yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You upset he's signing for Celtic and not Rangers?
No, I'm not. I like the two teams. I like Celtic
Rangers.
You're
such a liar.
No.
However, Celtic might face some competition for his signature because the Bologna striker is also wanted by FC 20, so we'll keep an eye on that one. So if you hear of any juicy gossip, get into us on our socials, which is Big Football Scott.
Oh, I think he scored the weekend against Milan. Bologna played Milan yesterday. Yesterday. I watched a little
bit. Did Hooijdonk score?
I think it was score because...
Producer John, can you quickly Google that for me?
We'll check that out.
Because the Derek Ferguson's son, Louis Ferguson, play. He's the captain for
Bologna. For Bologna. Yeah, yeah. What was the score?
I think win one now. I don't know.
Did Bologna win?
I don't know. When I left, 0-0, but I saw a picture, they celebrate. I think he scored. I don't know.
You think he scored? And yeah. Louis Ferguson has had an outstanding season at
Definitely
Bologna.
Class. The boy's good.
The
very
boy's
good.
Very, very good.
I just
good.
Feel Scotch boys don't have a chance here. Go play abroad.
Oh, totally.
Yeah.
Do it.
You know what I mean?
If you get the opportunity, go.
Not yeah. St. Paul Lambert as well. Just went to Dortmund.
Dortmund. What, the European Cup?
Exactly. Yeah. Football's...
Look at Andy Robertson at Liverpool.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry, go on, John.
It was 2-2 in the end, Jose.
Yeah.
Bologna got their goal from a penalty in the last second minute of injury time.
There to get a draw.
And Loftus-Cheek got two for Milan. There you go.
See?
All right. And did Van Hooydonk score?
No, he didn't. No.
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 Did he play?
I'll have a look.
Yeah, I think played.
Lewis Ferguson would have played.
No, he's the captain. Yeah.
Lewis Ferguson played and he got booked, but Van Hooydonk didn't. Wasn't even on the bench.
Right, oh. That's why he's okay. leaving, because he couldn't risk playing him
okay.
because mm-hmm. he might be leaving to go to Celtic or mm-hmm. FC20, so okay. we'll keep an eye on that. Right, let's do this. VARWTF.
La gente está muy loca. What the fuck?
Right, this is where we discuss some of the big VAR issues.
Okay.
In Scottish football at the weekend. Now, the problem we have here is that Jose Quitongo doesn't like football, doesn't
no,
watch football,
yeah, I'm not watching.
Doesn't have a clue what's going on. No. Mm-hmm. So, John, can you do me a wee favour, mate? Can we just take a wee break here?
Yep.
And I'm going to just show him some of the clips for VAR
okay, so, we can do that.
So that he can have an opinion on
okay.
it.
Yep.
Right, mm-hmm. so let's take a wee break here.
5 minutes later.
Right, we're back. Let's do this. Mm-hmm. Are you ready? You've watched the clips. Here we go. Mm-hmm. So, St Mirren versus Rangers, 1-0. Nothing in that game really discussed when it comes to VAR. Celtic 1, Ross County 0. Now, the penalty for Celtic, Simon Murray made the foul on Callum McGregor. We've just watched that, Jose. Mm-hmm. Was that a penalty?
Yeah, I think it was a penalty.
Yeah, yeah. I agree with you. I think there was contact.
Contact, yeah.
Was there enough contact for Callum McGregor to fall over?
Yes, because when you play football, this is what happened. You're not possession. We taught you, you know what I mean? I know people sometimes say dive, but you know...
It wasn't a dive for you.
Not a dive, no. It's penalty.
Penalty, so yeah. There you go. Mm-hmm. Hearts 2, Aberdeen 0. So the Miowski goal, which is an absolute peach of the goal. It would have been one of the goals this season had it stood. Mm-hmm. But in the lead up to the goal, Benny Beningame was tripped by Miowski. Mm-hmm. It was accidental, but they've still ruled the goal out. So if there's an accidental clash of two players and it leads to a goal, is that a foul?
It's a foul.
It is a foul.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you think it's a foul?
It's a foul because the build-up, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Was the build-up? Yeah, it's a foul.
It's a foul. So you think it was a good decision to rule the goal out? Okay.
Good goal, but yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Good decision.
Okay. Nicky Devlin, handball. Led to a penalty for Hearts. Now, here's the thing about this one. Mm-hmm. As I feel sorry for Devlin, mm-hmm. but he's jumping with his hand up, mm-hmm. and he tries to pull his hand away, but still strikes his arm. Is it a penalty?
It's a penalty. Yeah, this is the new rule, a penalty.
But, Jose, you're a former professional player, right?
Yeah.
See when you jump for the ball?
Yeah.
But you can't keep your hands by your side.
Yeah, you can't, but you jump, see the ball, you move.
Move the hand
You
there.
See everybody now, like, look.
Yeah. 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 So when your hand's out...
You need to move.
And if you...
It's a touch, it's penalty. This is what happened.
Okay.
You know?
So Jose thinks that's a penalty, 2-0 to Hearts in that one. Kilmarnock 2, Hibs 2, foul on Venti for the own goal from Vassell. Nah, we're okay with that one. Now, this is the one. The Ndaba yellow card. Uh-huh. It was initially a yellow card for the foul on Jair, and then they've upgraded it to a red card. I thought that was harsh. Now, in today's mm-hmm. game,
yeah.
if your foot's high, stud high, and it hits your ankle, you're running the risk of a red card.
Red card, yeah.
Do you think that's a red card?
Yes. High feet.
High feet.
Yeah.
Red card.
Red card. Mm. You should know, should be. Before in the past, yeah, you can jump, you can go, yeah. But now, the rules.
You can't do that.
You can't do that. You can't.
Even though you win the ball.
Even win the ball, yeah.
If your foot's high and the follow through.
Red card.
Red card.
Yeah.
Producer John, I want your thoughts on this one, because this is a big one for me at the weekend.
Yeah.
It turns the game mm-hmm. in Hibs' favour.
Mm-hmm.
Producer John, is that a red card?
I don't think, absolutely not. See, the art of tackling, it's now not allowed. It's like you can't tackle in a game now. For me, he won the ball. I don't know what angle, I think Derek McInnes was complaining about the angle that the referee saw it at. He went through the guy, he won the ball for me. I know there was a wee bit after.
But is it not high? You think it's high?
Yeah, I think if high foot, even just a little bit on the ground, high foot is...
And studs showing, that's the problem.
I know, but he won the ball, Ewan. He won the ball for me. I was questioning whether it was even a yellow card at first, but you know, McInnes wasn't happy with it.
You imagine... Graham Soon play now. For the time.
What? There you go. It's another Rangers player.
No.
Any opportunity you get. No. I mean, you could have mentioned Neil Lennon, Paul Lambert, but no. Because, but when Graham Soon is played.
No, because look, I watch a wee video. He's like, you know what I mean?
You love the Rangers, don't you?
No, I love it. You love all Rangers. The teams. I love. I'm a football person. Yeah, I love all the teams.
Well. It appears like you've got more love for Rangers than anybody else.
I'm no.
Let's go to Livingston versus Dundee. Couple of incidents here. First penalty was inside the box. I felt, yes, we've got no problems with that. It's inside the box. You've got a push on the line. That's a penalty for me. Second penalty was a foul on Nubley. Yes, it's just a foul and a penalty. Yeah, we both agree on that one. Foul on Mellon on Penrice for Dundee's third. My pal James Penrice gets a push. That third goal should never have stood, and that took the wind out of the sails for Livingston. So I think that Livingston can count themselves unlucky there. And the fourth goal scored by Dundee, checked by VAR because Boateng was offside. He wasn't interfering with play, so the referee got that one right. So a mixed bag for the referees at the weekend. But overall, do you like VAR, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, he's into VAR, that's fine. St Johnstone 1, Motherwell 1, nothing to report there. Okay, are we ready, sir, for some quick fire questions for our guest today, Jose Quitongo? Let's do the chat thing.
Jose.
Quick fire questions, Jose Quitongo. Beer or wine?
I never drink wine or beer.
Ever?
Never touch that.
Do you drink any alcohol?
Never in my life.
What do you drink?
Lemon tea and water. And sometimes maybe fresh orange lemonade. Yeah.
Okay. So, lemonade or orange juice?
Orange juice.
Okay. Bath or shower?
Shower.
No bath?
Yeah, but baths take long. Shower just quick, like, you
know. Do you not like to soak?
Yeah, you know what I mean? Can people run the bus and then, you know what I mean?
Running it, waiting
yeah,
for
waiting
it.
Yeah, just shower.
And then you sit in it, then you get bored.
Then, you know what I mean? No.
It's not for
shower,
you.
Shower, not for me.
Best player you've played with?
Best player I played with?
In all your years?
With or against?
With.
With.
With and against?
Rui Costa.
Played with?
Yeah.
You played with Rui Costa?
Yeah, in Portugal. Yeah.
Okay, so he was the best player you played with?
Yeah.
Against?
Against. I played with a million players, but I put it, Erik Larsson.
Henrik Larsson?
Yeah.
Best player you've ever played against?
Yeah.
Okay. Little Mix or Spice Girls?
Spice Girl.
Who's your favourite Spice Girl?
I like all them.
Like all them?
Yeah.
Leather or lace?
Leather. Leather, yeah. I have actually leather trousers. Leather.
You wear leather trousers?
Yeah, cool. With boots, it look fun, you know.
So you prefer leather to lace?
Yeah, leather.
If your girlfriend was to wear leather or lace, what would you prefer?
Yeah, lace. Yeah, she can wear lace, I wear leather. Yeah.
Hardest defender you've played against? The toughest, hardest defender you've played against?
Carlos Moser.
Who?
His name is Carlos Moser. He's a Brazilian player. He used to play for Brazil. He played for, Marseille and played for Benfica. He's the, like a dog player I ever see. He like, he do like...
Elbowing, dirty player.
Yeah. He's tall and like...
Strong. Kick you off the park.
Yeah, he's a... Even we used to train in the first team against the young. Oh, you're scared. You need to put everything because he's...
Really?
Animal. Yeah.
Wow. Just when it comes to defenders in Scotland.
Oh, Scotland, yeah.
Who's a really hard defender? Who's really tough and quite nasty and stood on your foot, kicked
them.
You.
All them.
All of them.
Yeah, all them, yeah. Because the way I used to play, I you know what I mean? See, when I used to play, and this I always say to the kids, I'm like fun. I love carry. No carry on. This is the way I play.
Yes.
You know, just
character, personality.
Yeah, the guys like started like, we're gonna kick that. I remember one my pal used to play for Eddie say, Jose, we used to bet who's gonna kick you first. Yeah. This is like, you know.
Okay. Boxers or briefs?
Boxer.
Butter or margarine?
Butter.
Comedy or horror?
Comedy.
Best goal you've ever scored?
Best goal. I scored, let me see. I scored a lot of goals.
You scored some good goals for Hearts.
Yeah, but best one.
Which one stands out for you?
Submitting. This, I remember I went to train with Greenock Bolton.
Uh-huh.
Play against Submitting.
Right.
Yeah, Submitting just promoting the Premier League. We play friendly before the season started. I score a belter with left foot top corner. Monday, I signed 2-year deal with Samaritan.
Yeah. Because of that goal.
Because that goal, bang, top corner. Left peg.
Two-year deal.
2-year deal.
Brilliant.
Bang.
Soft or hard?
I'm in the middle. Like,
no, you need to pick one. What do you prefer, soft or hard?
Soft. Man.
Netflix or Disney?
Netflix.
Mm-hmm. Batman or Superman?
Superman.
Party animal or stay at home?
Stay at home.
Real or fake?
Real.
Best manager you worked with?
I like all them. I like Jim Jeff.
Jim Jeffries.
Jim Bella Brown, I love them too. Yeah, they always look after me. Yeah, I love all
of
them.
Of all the managers you played with, it was Jim Jeffries the one for you?
Yeah, I love because he always look after me.
Oh, nice.
You know what I mean?
That's nice. I'm glad to hear that. Mm-hmm. Leonardo DiCaprio or Brad Pitt?
Jeez, that... Draw.
No, you can't have draws.
Okay. Brad Pitt.
Star Wars or Marvel Avengers?
Star Wars.
Good lad. Yeah. Jerry Cinnamon or Louis Capaldi?
Louis Capaldi.
Rangers or Celtic?
I love this game. No,
you have to pick one.
I pick one.
It's Rangers, isn't it?
No, I'm not. I'm not saying nine.
Mate, you have to answer.
Yeah?
If you had to pick one.
I say draw. I like the two teams.
Oh, shut up.
Ah, you know what I mean?
Okay, right. Can we have a drone for this next question? We need a drone. Right. We're going to get a drone.
Okay.
Right. This is a big, big question. Need a drone, John. Get this fired out, mate.
No
right?
problem.
A dramatic drone.
Okay.
I would like you, Jose Quitongo, here and now, on the Big Scottish Football Podcast, to name every single football club that you played for in Scotland.
In Scotland, okay. Yeah.
Right, hold on a second, let me get my list.
Holy moly.
Every club you played for in Scotland.
Okay. Even junior?
Everything.
Yeah, okay.
No every problem. Club. You ready?
Yeah.
Go.
Hamilton Nikes.
Yeah.
Arts.
Yeah.
Samaritan.
Yeah.
Kelly.
Yeah.
Alloa.
Yeah.
Dumbarton.
Yeah.
No, Dumbarton, Alloa. Glen Afton.
Yeah.
Milkirk.
Yeah.
Patrick Tasso.
Yeah.
I think that. Who I play again?
Is that many?
Yeah. But, hey, man. I can't remember the other ones.
But, 2006, before Partick Thistle, where were you? Something Rovers.
Albion Rovers?
You played with Albion Rovers?
No, I never played with Albion Rovers.
You did?
I played for Albion Rovers. No.
You did?
I trained. People just put that.
No, you played with Albion Rovers.
I played for Albion Rovers?
Yeah. You played one game for them.
Yeah?
Yeah.
No, I played one game for Dumbarton.
No. You played for Albion Rovers.
Yeah?
Yeah. You were at Albion Rovers, then Partick Thistle, then Dumbarton.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Jeez.
Right? So, after Dumbarton, where did you go?
To Italy.
Right, yes. Yeah. But where did you go after Italy? We're talking about Scottish football club.
Oh, and then I come back. Where? Scottish football.
You came back.
Come back.
To a Scottish club.
Club.
Who are in the Premier League just now.
Submitting?
No.
Hamilton?
No.
Premier League now?
Premier League now. They've got a plastic pitch.
Livingston, no.
Yeah.
I play in Livingston. Yes, no, I train in Germany.
No, see, you were in Livingston.
But I trained.
You
remember
were at
Snowgrass.
Livingston.
We used to have me, Snowgrass, and Grimdorn. You know, it's training. I just have a...
But you were at Livingston.
Yeah, I wasn't Livingston.
Right, okay. Well,
yeah.
That's okay. The answer.
Yeah.
So after Livingston, where did you go for a season and play 10 games?
I don't know.
You don't don't know.
Hamilton?
No. No. After Livingston.
Aloha. Stenhousemuir?
Yes. You got 10 games at Stenhousemuir. Yeah. You then went to Glen Afton, which you said. Yeah. And then after Glen Afton, you went to...
Muirkirk?
No, that was your last club. You had two more clubs before Muirkirk. So between Glen Afton and Muirkirk, you got two more clubs.
Glen Afton, Muirkirk. Where I went?
So two in between those two, and you've got them all.
Oh, man.
You played twice at this club in 2010 after Glen Afton.
Gee. What?
It begins with a P.
Pete?
Mate, you played for them. No. It's a junior side. Them.
Pollock.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah,
and then after Pollock you went to...
Pollock. It's junior as well.
Junior.
L. Les Mayego?
Yes!
Yeah, Les Mayego.
And then finally...
Muirkirk.
Muirkirk, that's it.
Player manager, be sack, man.
You were player manager? How long were you player manager?
I was the... No, like Caesar. No, player manager, not team. You know what I mean? I used to manage, but I used to play as well, which is good.
Yeah. You know. Well done, you. We finally got there. You got all the teams you played for in Scotland. Mm-hmm. Okay, now, Jose, it is now time for the quiz.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
It's called the Big Shootout.
Okay.
Yes. Like a penalty shootout, each of us will receive quite five questions and we then take it in turns to answer with the victor getting the bragging rights for the week.
Okay.
So, you're playing for Stephen Mill.
Okay.
He's winning 16-5.
Okay. 17-5.
17-5.
Steve, I'm not going to let you down, my man.
So, here we go. So, now, I have already discussed this with producer John.
Okay.
And what we've decided for your questions is that you're getting questions on all the clubs you played for.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So, just see how well you know the clubs that you played for. We're testing your knowledge on that.
Oi.
So I've agreed to that before we even start.
Okay.
I'm just getting the normal five questions.
Okay.
Whoever gets the most points,
you win.
Wins.
Okay.
Okay. All so right. Do you want a pen, paper, station to write stuff down?
Mm-hmm.
I'll go first.
Mm-hmm.
Or do you want to know, flip a coin. Do you want to go heads or tails?
Yeah.
Heads or tails?
Tail.
Tails.
Mm-hmm.
Tails it is. Do you want to go first or second?
I'll go second, no problem.
Second, okay.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Right, I'll go first, so give me my question.
Okay, Ewen, first question for you is which team won last year's Challenge Cup? Which team won last year's Challenge Cup? Or Trust Trophy, or Tunnocks Trophy, or Iron Brew Trophy, or whatever it's called now.
Oh my God.
The Petrofac, it was called that one.
I actually think, because I had a pal that was there, it was at the Falkirk Stadium.
It was at the Falkirk Stadium.
I think that's Hamilton.
Hamilton, final answer.
Final answer.
Final answer is Hamilton, and it is... Correct.
Question number one for Jose.
Right, Jose, your question. One of your former clubs, Aloha, what animal do they have on their badge? What animal does Aloha have on their badge?
Bee. Yeah. Bee. What's it called? Bee.
Kind of like a bee.
Is it a bee?
No bee. What's it called?
It's the nickname of the team, the, Jose.
Yeah, the
it's
the
like
nickname,
a bee. Like
it's
a
like
bee.
A bee. There's another thing, but it's not a bee.
No,
yeah, it is like a bee. It's like the cousin of the bee, the nastier version of a bee.
What's a bee? He's a bee.
What? No, it's with a W.
Oh, fuck. Oh, man.
Not wallaby.
No, I don't say wallaby. I'm like... Start with W.
I'm helping you here. Yeah. You were with this club for how long?
I'm not even see the badges.
I mean, it's on your chest for 2 years.
But I'm not even see the badge. Start W. Oh, I can't remember. I can. You and I can.
Well, you're not getting it for B.
Help.
No, what? I'm against you. I'm not helping you.
No, but you know what I mean.
What's the nastier cousin of a B?
Fuck.
It's all right, you can say what you like. So you're fine, you've said enough on this podcast.
I can't. My brain, I can't.
He's not getting it for B, by the way.
Right, okay.
A B, I say B.
No!
The B.
No, you're not getting it for B.
Come on, give me the B. What's no?
No.
Steve, I say B.
No, you're not getting it. Is that your final answer, B?
Yeah. What's the name? Yeah. Yeah.
It's a wasp.
Wasp. Exactly. Listen.
Don't you just shout at me?
No. I meant to say wasp.
It doesn't matter.
No. You trick me because.
How did I trick you?
You trick me because I meant to say wasp. Yeah, I meant to say that. I say B. I tell you that. You trick me. No. I'm not take that one. You trick me.
No. That everyone can hear that and watch that on YouTube. I never tricked you.
Okay,
nothing.
Okay, no problem. Yeah,
you're 1-0 down.
Okay.
Right. Well, he sounds like you, Ewen.
Yeah, you know what I mean? No.
No, but did you say wasp?
Yeah, I said yeah.
No, you said B.
B, yeah.
Right. Okay. But did you at any point say wasp?
No, but
there's no. No, it's no. But move on. No, shut up, you. Shut up.
Right, you in your question.
Question two. Go on.
Jose Cervantes joined Rangers from which club? Jose Cervantes joined Rangers from which club? He's obviously under transfer speculation at the moment.
So he came from the MLS. Mm-hmm. Cifuentes came from the MLS. Oh, was it the Earthquakes?
The Earthquakes?
Was it not the San Jose Earthquakes?
Are they called the Earthquakes? That's a bit inappropriate for a football team name, isn't it?
I don't know. Have I just made that up?
You made that.
I'm going to check that.
Just check that.
It sounds like something that Americans would call their team after a natural disaster. San Jose Earthquakes. Let's just.
I think. Well, it can't necessarily answer.
Was that not in the Hurricanes, the TV cartoon back? But San Jose Earthquakes. You're right, Ewen. You're right. San Jose Earthquakes.
By the way, that just ruled it out.
That's not the.
So it's not them. Is it Montreal? Did he come from Montreal? Did he come from Montreal? Oh no, I should know this. Come on, you're a Rangers fan. Help me out here.
Me? No.
Don't help him, Jose.
I'm not.
Shit.
Just remember, you need WB.
I
remember talking about this with Stephen as well. Oh, I'm going to kick myself here. MLS.
Look at the time.
Shut up, you. There's no time on this. I'm really going to kick myself. Is it Montreal? No, it's not Montreal.
It was.
Philadelphia. I'm going to. Oh, God, what is it? I'm going to go final answer. Philadelphia.
Final answer, Philadelphia.
Yeah.
Who
is it?
Yes.
It was Los Angeles FC.
Did he come from LAFC?
LAFC, yep, he did.
Decent team as well.
Right, Jose, your next question.
Okay.
This is to equalise. In what year did you join Hamilton for your second spell? Not your first spell. What year did you join for your second spell?
I've got the answer on this.
Let me see. For second spell.
For the second spell.
The year.
A year.
The year that you joined for your second spell.
2000.
I'm not telling you.
I'm not saying you tell me. 2000 and. 2000.
Final answer.
Wait.
Is that your final answer?
2001?
No, just say if it's your final answer. You want to go 2000 or 2001, Jose?
What do you think? No, 2000.
2000, final answer. Correct.
Oh, no. Correct.
Bring it on, pal.
Right. 1-1. Question
right,
three.
Okay, you in your next question.
Can I just say, at this moment, I'm shitting myself. He just spat water all over himself.
Right, Ewen.
Go on.
Which Scottish...
Can I also just say, I'll never live this down if I lose today.
No, absolutely not.
My God. Thank God.
Right, shut up, there's only way to go.
Which Scottish football team have adopted Love is in the Air as their anthem?
Love is in the air. Love
is in the air. When I look around. Yeah.
Yeah.
This one.
Love is in the air.
So a club in Scotland has adopted that song?
Yeah.
Love is in the air. It's not a Premiership club. You don't even watch football, so you're having it.
Of course he knows the song, though.
I know.
He doesn't know Subway the Best, he doesn't know Never Walk Alone, but he knows this one.
Did you give me the leak there?
What?
When you asked me that question, did you give me the leak?
No, I didn't, no.
No.
Just to see which Scottish club?
Which Scottish club?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I'm getting really worried now.
I can sing Love in the Air.
No, you just shut up.
When I look at...
you shoot? What? There's still three questions to go.
I'm rubbing your hands if you're about to win it. No, I'm just...
Love is in the air. Love is in the air. Who would adopt that song? I wonder if you're trying to trick me here, and I wonder if it's one of wonder if it's one of Hosey's former clubs.
No. Oh, yeah.
Shut up. I'm going to go. I think you might be playing with me here. I'm going to go Alloa.
Going to go Alloa.
Final answer.
Final answer is yeah. Alloa.
Oh no!
Yes. There we go. It was Dundee United.
Is it?
Yep.
Yeah, they're singing.
Yep, they sing it all.
Love it any year. This is what happens.
Yeah, Hosey knows it.
Hosey, if you get this question right, you go 2-1 up.
Right, Hosey.
Bring it on, pal. Bring it on. Help the brother here. Let's go.
Help the brother.
What was the name of the Italian team you played for?
Oh, the Italian team I played for?
Yeah.
that's so easy, pal. His name Lezzone.
I've never heard of them.
Yeah, it's a team nearly Italy. 50
what league were they in?
It's Serie C.
Serie C.
C, yeah, before
Pro
that.
Pro Lezzone.
Lezzone, this is my team, yeah. I play. Hey! Jose in the lead!
Right.
Oh no.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, no. Steve, pal, I make you proud, my man.
Remember, the top bin is always available for you. Right. Jurgen Klopp obviously been in the news this week after he's announced his retirement from Liverpool.
Yeah.
What club did he start his managerial career at?
Mainz, final answer.
Mm-hmm. Mainz, final answer.
Yeah.
2-2. Bring it on.
2-2.
4-5, eh? 4-5.
This is your question number 4. You can go 3-2 up here.
Holy moly.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Jose.
Yeah.
You played for Les Mahago.
Yeah.
But can you name which Scottish council region Les Mahago is in?
Oh, come on. Come on.
What a question that is.
That's not nice. That's great. Come on.
Come on. Which council region is that in? Where is Les Mahago?
Les Mahago is... Let me see. Where's that?
You played there.
Yeah, but I just got play. Les Mahago is...
You play a manager there?
No, I just play.
Just play?
Yeah. Les Mahago is... So.
I mean, you travelled there.
Yeah, but just travel. Somebody take me there. Man, Les Mahago is...
Stephen Mill is counting on you. Don't let him down.
Stephen, man.
There he is on the but screen.
But that question is crazy. No south. No, that's no. It's country. No, that's no south. No.
What are you thinking?
So no. Mm-mm. Pass.
You can't pass.
You can't.
Oh, can't pass. Oh
no.
Oh, can't pass.
No, you have to give us an answer. Mate, so you played there.
Yeah, but I just go at night time. I don't even see where I'm going. You know what I mean? Jesus, I stay.
So, try and picture it in your head.
Look, I'm close all. South Lanarkshire? No.
South Lanarkshire?
Yeah.
Final answer?
I don't know. Are you looking at me?
Ewen, come on, man.
It's up to you.
South Lanarkshire, final answer, Jose.
No, South.
Say yes.
Yes. Them do bad flip.
He's just done a cartwheel off mic. He's just done a cartwheel off mic.
Right, okay.
Thank you, what a go. Thank you, Jose. Steve, I no let it down, my pal.
Right, okay, no, here we go. Right.
Well, yeah. Wait, where are we sitting here? We're 3-2 to him.
Yeah.
We're 3-2 to him, which means I've got to get this question right or he wins the quiz.
Oh my God. I'm the one to sleep tonight.
Yeah. You need to get this one right.
Go on then, give me it.
New Celtic signing Nicholas Kuhn is what nationality? What nationality is new signing for Celtic Nicholas Kuhn? Nicholas Kuhn.
Look at the name. Nicholas What's his second name? Nicholas?
K-H-U-N.
Hun. He's from that country.
Shut up. You're being a complete and utter smart arse now. Right? You're being a smart arse.
He deserves to be. This is to tie you. This is to
Yun,
tie.
Look at the name.
Shut up. You're just as bad as fucking Stephen Mill. Nicholas Kuhn.
Look at Nicholas Kuhn. That's a good name.
But where's he from?
I'm going to help you, like...
Shut up!
No, I'm going
to... Jose, I don't want your help.
Listen, I'm going to give you a wee...
No.
See, Shevchenko's country, the same...
Shevchenko?
Yeah.
Shut up!
It's the same country.
Shut up!
Well, I tell you that. Well, answer then.
See if I don't get this right.
No!
See if you beat me.
No, I'm joking.
By the way, I'm walking out. And you're going to end the show.
No problem. Go, Jose.
Nicholas Kuhn.
Look at the name.
Oh,
Thomas. God. Oh! Change my mind. Thomas. Oh, chairman.
He's just been in the news. How have I not picked up on this? Ah!
Listen. So what happened, pal? Sometimes
Jose, I'm telling you now.
Aye.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You need to shut up while
okay.
I'm thinking.
No problem. Okay.
Mm-mm.
Not here.
I'm going to say final answer. And I'm telling you right now, if you win this, I'm walking out.
No walks. Come on, Dick.
Right. Final answer. Sweden.
Sweden, final answer.
Yeah.
Sweden, final answer.
Uh-huh.
For Hosey to win it, you need to get this wrong, Ewen.
Yeah.
If you hear there's the ball has been saved here, Hosey, you win. If Ewen, you hear the sound go, it is going to a tie break.
Yeah. Mamma mia.
Here it's we go.
The moment of truth has arrived.
Yeah. And Marshall is saved!
Jose Quitongo beats Ewen Cameron!
Thank you. I know that. I'm clever sometimes when I use my brain.
What was the answer?
German.
I tell you that. I tell you Germany.
Jose actually said German at one point. You didn't listen to
you. You don't
Jose.
Listen to me. Exactly. He's ignoring me. I say German. She's like, shh. Jose, shut up.
Enjoy your victory,
do
Jose.
Do your victory speech. Victory speech.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you to all my family. To all my family in the jungle. Thanks so much. I love you all. Thank you.
pack the bag, Ewen. Pack the bag. Pack the little bag.
Well
You've
done,
been defeated you. By Jose Quitongo.
Thank you.
There we go.
Stevie, thank you, my man. Win for you, pal. Enjoy your holiday in Barcelona.
Ewen, you've got to wrap up the show. Don't leave.
Bye. I'm away. See you later.
See ya.
Oh, shut up, you.
Okay. Listen. Hello, everyone. Jose win. You have a good day. Enjoy. Bye. what? Ewen, good. I love. This is my show. Yeah. Oh, I love you, Yun. Yun is good. Yun, you are amazing. I love it.